Today's quote is entitled, "We suffer when we inflict pain on others." Suniti said to Prahlad, "My dear son, don't wish for anything inauspicious for others. Anyone who inflicts pains upon others suffers himself from that pain." In this story of Dhruva Maharaj, Dhruva obviously, if you know the story, was very upset and he wanted to take revenge. So his mother wisely said, "Well, if you take revenge on someone, then it's going to hurt you more than it's going to hurt them, because when you try to inflict pain upon another person, you also inflict pain upon yourself. When you're angry with another person, you also suffer from the anger. When we're envious of another person, we suffer from the envy." Now, you can flip that around. When you're kind to someone or you're compassionate, you experience the kindness or the compassion. And there's a saying in Bengal that if you kill a skunk, your hand will smell. So when we do something wrong, the smell or the odor, the skunky odor, it wears off on us, and we carry that around with us. So there's no way you can buck the system. There's no way you can get around this, because there's immediate karmic reaction when we act improperly, or we in any way are unkind or hateful or spiteful or revengeful or vengeful towards another person. We always end up suffering an immediate karmic consequence, because that's just the nature of the way things are. So when I first became very clear about this, it was very, you know, it's a very obvious point, but a lot of things which are obvious are not obvious. A lot of things which are very simple are very profound, because we don't really focus on them. We don't really become clear about them. So when I first understood this, I thought, this is so simple, but it's so profound. Why would I be envious if ultimately I'm the one I'm punishing? Why would I be jealous? Why would I allow myself to be resentful if ultimately all that's happening is I'm punishing myself for my own resentment or my own jealousy or my own anger? And as I understood this, it helped me tremendously when I was about to respond with envy or jealousy or resentment or whatever, because immediately I became aware that all I'm doing is punishing myself. And this is really foolish. I've got nothing to gain. I'm not going to get upper hand on anyone, but I'm only going to destroy myself. Then the thing that happened further, which made it a little more intense, we could say a little more scary or real, was that I did some research about the effects of negative emotions on our physical well-being. And I found many, many, well, for lack of a better word, scary things relating negative emotions like hatred and resentment and jealousy and so forth, relating to diseases of the heart, diseases caused by immune system wearing down due to stress that these emotions cause. And then the real scary thing was the correlation between resentment and cancer. These are real live people doing real life research, and a lot of research has come out in the last 10 or 15 years. So our own resentment, our own envy, our own hatred and so forth, it is destructive to us. And it's very, very helpful to be aware of this. It's a strong impetus to control ourselves, to try to be kinder and better. And don't you think if you're kinder and more compassionate, you'll be happier? Maybe you'll even live longer. Maybe you can do more service for Krishna because you're in a positive state. It's obvious, isn't it? So I hope these thoughts can kind of be digested within your system. So the next time you're tempted to respond to a situation in a negative way, remember that ultimately that response is going to be your own undoing. You're just punishing yourself. Although you think you're getting back or getting even or whatever, you're actually just punishing yourself.
Hare Krishna. If you like this video, you can subscribe below. Also, I'd really appreciate it if you share this video with others, if you comment on it, if you like it, do whatever you have to click to share it, because I think a lot of devotees would appreciate getting these videos. I try to take our philosophy and put it in a practical way so we know how to apply it in daily activity. And this is one of the services I do, and I want to reach as many devotees as possible. If you can help me, I'd appreciate it so much. Thank you.